Yes, for my marriage. And,
are you not inform all the Christians of the church that you are getting married?
No, I just consulted with the board and said, okay, I'll tell you more this evening in church. And
so, Pastor, you looked in the church and you didn't see any sister. You decided to go and bring a total, because I don't know her. I mean, that she's not a member of our church. So you decided to go and bring somebody from elsewhere.
No, she's
after all the sisters are in the church, we have been there for you. I bring seats every day. I bring tithes every day. I make sure that you have food on your table. My, you will not look at me and say, no, excuse me, Pastor. Doctor, let me say my mind. No, man of God, it's not that I don't respect you. I respect you, but let me say my mind. I bring seats and tithes and I bring offering. You don't see any sister in the church like some of us. You go and bring a sister. I don't know whether I don't have any personal problem with you, my dear. So I'm talking to my man of God because he's my pastor. And as far as he's my pastor, I have the right to tell him what I think. Disappointed in you. So some of these things that you men of God do that. You know, and people like us have to tell you the right thing. I'm really disappointed. I don't even need your invitation because I'm not coming for the wedding. As it is, I'm pregnant for you.
Eh?
Yes. Maybe you start telling her right now.
No, excuse me, my daughter. Mm-hmm. Are you joking?
I'm not joking with the man of God. I'm pregnant for you.
When? How? By the Spirit?
Let me explain. My seat of faith, my tithes, a father I've given you, has impregnated me. So as it is like this, I'm already pregnant for you.
Look, my daughter.
Mm-hmm. Because I cannot sow, and another person comes and reap. So I don't know how we are going to handle the case. So if I were you, Pastor, we take a wise decision. You have to be wise.
My daughter.
Don't allow your ministry to fall, though. Don't allow Jezebel to come and destroy your ministry. Because this one, you don't know her. At least us, you know us. Might be a Jezebel. I didn't call anybody Jezebel. I'm just saying it. That's what is coming to my spirit.
My daughter, see, the things of God, we don't force them. It is not by carnal
means. You would have refused my title and seat of faith when I was bringing it. You would have refused it. It's not my fault. You would have refused it. I said, no, sister, leave it.
I pray
for you. So you thought I was doing that for nothing? No, I was not doing for nothing.
I pray fervently for God's blessings upon you.
No.
Please. The moment.
Let her go. Who is it? Let her leave the place.
The moment.
Who has refused?
I am struggling.
That is why we have been sowing into the ministry. Yes. And that we have sowed, and another person will come and reap where they did not sow.
I have prayed.
But every day they want preaching that you can only reap where you sow. Some of us have sowed. Other people come and reap.
But you have reaped also from the vineyards.